உங்களுக்கு அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். நான் தமிழில் பேச விரும்புகிறேன், ஆனால் கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சம் தெரியும். சிங்களை இங்கிலீஷில் கதாக்கிறேன். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் ஐ வுட் லைக் டு தேங்க் மிஸ்டர் சிவலிங்கம் அண்ட் அதர்ஸ் டு ஆர்கனைஸ் திஸ் டைப் ஆஃப் மீட்டிங். ஆக்சுவலி யூ ஆல் ஆஃப் already know very well about that Sri Lanka has changed some extent before the 8th of last January in 2015. We as a party, we did a big role in that regime change because we wanted to implement the real democracy in our country, and we want to build the national unity in our country. That's why we as a party involved that political change. But unfortunately, the present government has not fulfilled all dreams of the people of Sri Lanka and who are living outside the country. The mandate was not given for the coalition government. Actually, mandate was given for the UNPA. The majority was given to UNP. But after the general election, they have formed a coalition government. They promised to the Sri Lankan people to do many things, economically and politically. There are so many promises. I think I do not want to mention again. They said to the people to do many things in the economic field, but there are no anything. Actually, the people who voted for MS and Ranil Wickremesinghe's parties, they are suffering a lot. Actually, they cannot say openly what they expected. Actually, they are ashamed because of forming this government. Economically, there are so many failures are there. Mike? Okay. Economically, there are so many failures. As far as concerned the democracy, we have completed some extent using the 19th Amendment. Actually, we could reduce the executive powers of the president. It is a great victory. Otherwise, today there is a most powerful executive president in our country, but because of the 19th Amendment, we could have succeeded some extent of that target. Now, the president of Sri Lanka has no more powers as far as concerning the former executive presidencies. We have formed so many independent commissions. The Independent Election Commission, Independent Police Commission, Independent Judiciary Commission. Likewise, there are 10-12 independent commissions are there. It is a victory, but it is not a full victory. Implementing those types of independent commission, we can come some extent of our target, but that is not the full democracy. But that was a starting point. And there is other so many bills were there. Right to Information Act was passed. It is also a victory of the people who are expecting the more democratic country. And the other thing is, without considering the joint opposition's oppose, we could have passed the other bill, office, what is called missing persons. Yeah, office of the missing persons bill. Those are the democratic changes. Actually, they are reforms. We cannot satisfy fully, but without changing that former regime, we cannot do that. Therefore, we can satisfy it. We cannot fully satisfy it, but we can satisfy it. Actually, it is a though they are reforms of the democracy, but they are the victory of the democracy. But there are many challenges. As far as concerned the national unity, there is no any positive signal. That is the unfortunate situation. Mr. Sivalingam mentioned that the constitution, the new constitution. There must be a new constitution because the present constitution is very old. It has passed in parliament in 1978. Now 36 years passed. Therefore, we must implement and introduce new constitution. Abolishing executive president's power and introducing a new electoral system, and there are some new clauses in that constitution how to unite our all nations, all ethnicities. That's how to build up our real national unity. Those are the three factors we must pay our attention in that new constitution. The government has started it, and government has promised to UNHRC, and government has taken some steps for that. You know, there are some committees in parliament. Parliament has changed to the Parliamentary Assembly, and there is a main committee that is called Steering Committee, and there are some other six subcommittees are there: Human Rights Committee, Finance Committee, and Law and how to run the State Committee. There are some other committees. The all six committees have submitted their reports, except the steering committee report. Steering committee is the main body which will take the final decisions. In that steering committee, there are many discussions are going on. As far as concerned the electoral system, all parties agreed 90% of that new system, except few clauses. We have to have further conversation regarding those clauses. Abolishing executive presidency. Actually, all parties have agreed there are some issues. I think you have already known about that, the SLFP party, the president's party. Some members of SLFP have said in some medias, they are not willing to abolish executive presidency system. They have taken some decisions remaining to executive presidency. But president has not said anything about that. He promised to people to abolish the executive presidency. Recently, Venerable Ratna Thera has decided to be an independent member of parliament. He said that in openly, no, executive presidency must not be removed, it must be remain. He mentioned and he explained using the manifesto of the SLFP, not SLFP, the good governance principles, the president's manifesto. There is no any clause in that manifesto removing the executive presidency. That was Venerable Ratna Thera's idea. Likewise, there are some other senior cabinet ministers and senior members of the SLFP. They also said that no, executive president system must not be abolished. But in that steering committee, they did not mention that. The main important issue, the ethnic issue. Actually, there are so many ideas are there. Some political parties demand for the full devolution of power. Some political parties did not agree that, and some political parties said that, yeah, there must be some extent of devolve the power. There are so many different ideas are there. As a political party, JVP, our party system, he mentioned that you are like to hear about our political stand. You know very well about that. In the past, we strongly against the separatist movement because we don't like to separate our country. Separatism is dividing the people, Tamil, Muslim and Sinhala people. Therefore, we opposed the separatism in the past, and today also we are opposing separatism, whatever the type of separatist movement. If it is a Muslim organization, if it is a Tamil organization, if it is a Sinhala organization, whatever the ethnicity, we oppose, separate our Sri Lankan people. That is the main base of our stand. We think the people must be given, the government must be given full powers to person. That is the real meaning of the devolution of power. If we consider the UK society or some other European societies, the person has many powers. If you go to court, there are no any discrimination. If you are Sri Lankan, if somebody belongs to United Kingdom, there is no any difference. There are few incidents are there, but if you take the whole society, there are no differences. Before the law, we have equal rights. If you go to the economic field, there are no differences. Whatever the ethnicity, whatever the country belongs to you. Sometimes you belong to Sri Lanka, sometimes you belong to India or Bangladesh. There are no differences in economic field. That is our principle. And we say, give full powers to whole persons. That is not opposing the devolution of power. That is the real devolution of power. But we don't like to give some ethnic group more powers who are living in a separate area. It may become a big issue, big problem in future. You know very well about the Sri Lankan society. Sinhala, Tamil and Muslim people are living together in Colombo, in Vellavatta, Vattala and Deniyar and Noorelli, Padumila and Batikalo and Tiyariya. There are Muslim and Sinhala people, they are living together. If we divide some area for one ethnicity, for example, if we form a eastern province separate zone for the Muslim people, then what will happen to the Muslim people who are living in Colombo? The majority Sinhala people will say, go in your place, your area, your zone. That is Muslim zone. This is not a Muslim zone. This is a Sinhala people's area. Then what will happen in the future? It will be a big problem. Likewise, we think forming a separate area and naming that area as a Muslim area and Tamil area, that is not a solution of the ethnic issue in our country. But giving more powers to Muslim people, giving more powers to Tamil people, giving more powers to Sinhala people, it's not a problem. Without considering the ethnicity, we can give more powers to people. That is our stand. Therefore, we categorically said that in 1987, before implementing the 13th Amendment, 13th Amendment is not a solution for the ethnic issue in our country. We are the party who said, first of all, now we have 38 years experience. Today, we can say, 13th Amendment is not a solution for the ethnic issue. That is the reality. That does not mean we do not like to give powers to Tamil, more powers to Tamil people or Muslim people. That does not mean we like to give more powers to Tamil people and Muslim people. But that is not the 13th Amendment. And that is our stand. And if you take another example, as a religion, as a Buddhist country or Tamil, Hindu country or Muslim country, I think our stand is the religion is people's right. Any government who are ruling the country, that government's main responsibility protect all rights of the all religious groups. We must not give more attention for any specific religion. In our manifesto, we have clearly mentioned that. Actually, there are some wrong clauses in the past Constitution, the 78 Constitution. For example, if we take the language issue, the clause clearly said that Sinhala is a state language. Tamil also a state language. There is a word also. It's totally discrimination. We oppose that. demanded several times to change that clause. But past government has not done it yet. It is a discrimination. Therefore, we must change that clause. We can easily say that Sinhala, Tamil and English also, all three languages are state languages in our country. In practical, English also state language. Though we agree or not, that's the real situation. If you go to the court, what is the language? Court hearing is asking. Hearing is going on in English language. In Supreme Court, Appeal Court, not even the Supreme Court and Appeal Court. If you go to the High Court and Magistrate Court, the whole court proceedings are going on in English language. Therefore, our state, our stand is Sinhala, Tamil and English are state languages. We can clearly say that. Therefore, we are appearing in that steering committee to change this past constitution, and we have to introduce some new chapters for the new constitution as far as concerning the human rights issue and the economic factor. Then we can build up the real powerful man in our country. That is the person who have obtained more powers, economically, politically, and culturally. There is a debate about the word unitary. The real situation in our country, if we go to change that word from the constitution, the single majority people will not agree with it. That is the situation. But without considering the word, we can use the suitable word for the constitution to build, how to build the national unity. But the important is that what is the meaning of the word?
Can you be precise about
that? Yeah, I will give
a... For the constitution, yeah. Your suggestions to the constitution.
Yeah.
You know, the individual rights and things like that is rubbish. Now what you are really proposing to the constitution.
Yeah, wait.
Please.
I will give you a chance after my explanation. That is the system of the conversation.
And we have heard your talk, you know, going to be giving this time.
Rona Vijayavira's stand is the our party stand.
Yeah, we have got that.
We are not deviated from that stand because that is.
I think we have issues at the moment. Ask questions. You answer according to reply to those needs. You know, you talk about constitution. That's a very important thing. But you are not telling.
Please wait and be patient. Yeah. I think as a doctor, you must be patient. No, I am not angry with the word. I am explaining. I think you must be patient.
I know you guys talk hours and hours. So.
I know your requirements. I can understand. But as a...
As a career.
Yeah, okay, no problem. As far as concerned the language issue, that was our stand. The first manifesto of JVP, it was released 1982. It clearly mentioned that Sinhala, Tamil, English should be national languages in our country. Before the 1983, before the insurrection has begun, we said that is our party stand. actually, if we want to unite the peoples of our country, the main base is the economy. Economy is the base of the society. If government can give the equal economic rights to all people who are living in the country, then national unity will be automatically built up. Because that is the base of the society. If there are no economic rights to all people, then there are some differences begun. The government can give equal economic rights to all people, then people do not think we face some discrimination. Give equal rights to all people on the basis of equality. Give equal rights to all people on the basis of equality. That is the solution of ethnic issue in all country, area in the world. But the problem is how to apply it, how to start the program for that. That is the challenge. The concept, the principle is to solve the ethnic problem, whichever the country. The main principle is give equal rights to all people on the basis of equality. The government can say about that, government can explain, but explanation and some other conversation are not important. The important thing is how to practically do it. That's why we have submitted some proposals just after the war. The war has finished 19th of May in 2009. JVP has submitted a
proposal.
Some proposals, the 14 proposals, to build the national unity just after the war. But then government has not paid their attention clearly. And again, we submitted another proposal 1 month after the war. The basic steps to reduce the differences of the ethnic groups, language, and build up the Northern East province, and how to start new projects for that, and how to change some wrong clauses in the constitution. Mentioning that, we have submitted proposals to then government, but they did not do that. There are some small changes. If you go to some area, there are no signboards in the offices in Tamil language. If you go to the University of Colombo, there is a signboard saying that University of Colombo, but in Tamil it is wrong, by mistake. Likewise, there are many faults are there. Therefore, we can start from that point, not the last point. From the beginning, we can start small thing, but though they are small, they are the main factors. People's attitude are changing. Therefore, we propose that 2009. And other example, if you go to the state plantation workers' life, in that birth certificates, it mentioned that the child belongs to Indian stamp. But our stand is, it must be changed. We can say Tamil. Our stand is, it must be Sri Lanka. But first step, it can be changed. It can be removed that part, first part, Indian. It belongs to Tamil. No problem. But in the state plantation, workers face that issue. Who opposed that? Who opposed to change that? The leaders of the upcountry area, the leaders of the CWC, Thonuman and others, they do not like to change that. They want to obtain their votes, categorically mentioning they are the Indian origin Tamils. But if we want to change that, the government can do it. Those are some examples we have proposed in 2009. Collecting all proposals, we have submitted and we have prepared a small book, the basic steps to solve the ethnic issue in our country. Establishing the civil administration in the northern and eastern provinces. We were the party who fought for that. After changing the government regime, the situation has also changed to some extent. And there are some proposals in that book to start. That is not the final. Starting proposals. Then, actually, if we can take those steps in our society, then there is no necessity to rename the constitution unitary or united or whatever. And there is no need for any separate area naming those area belongs to our people, because they think we have already obtained all economic and political rights, therefore we need not further any new area or new system. Government must fulfill main those economic and social requirements. Those are the basic steps which we can take immediately. Then people's attitude will change. Then people will not demand for a separate area or separate state. Without fulfilling those requirements, we cannot go beyond that. If somebody in their extreme idea, we won't separate area, we won't separate state, Sri Lanka never happened. We must understand the real situation of our country. It can be never happen. And it will be the main reason to start another critical situation. Therefore, we must not be extreme. We must be moderate. In our solution is give equal rights to all people on the equal basis of the equality, economical and the politically and culturally. Protect the Hindu people's religious rights. We think this type of government never fulfill those requirements. Even UNP or even SLMP or even coalition government, they will not fulfill those requirements. They are talking about that, but genuinely they don't like to do that. That's why the SLMP, for example, the SLMP, they also have changed their idea. Earlier they clearly said that, the president also clearly said that, as a party we like to go beyond the 13th Amendment. Now they are opposing that. And we, as a party, we clearly say 13th Amendment is not a solution. That is our stand. Therefore, we cannot beyond that, go beyond that. If we go beyond that, there will be a problem. Therefore, the first of all, we have to fulfill basic requirements of the people. The people who are living in Kilnochi and Muluthivu area, they are not demanding for the separate state. They are not demanding for a federal system. Who are creating that issue? The politicians. They use that issue on behalf of their political power. When we ask from them, what is your genuine idea? Those politicians are also explaining us. We are using that slogan as a slogan to obtain our vote. That is the idea. Therefore, our party stand is, we can build such a society. I think you can take a best example from the UK. United Kingdom, you are Sri Lankans. There are many British people are living here, but there are no differences. How? There are so many people are living here from various countries. There are no differences. But what is the base? The economy. We have equal economic rights. Whatever the system, whatever the name of the constitution, there is no constitution. There is no written constitution. But as far as concern our country, comparing our country, the people who are living in UK are obtaining more economic powers and political powers. The main thing is how to change the system. If we can change the system, then those attitudes of the people will also change. If it is difficult, actually, we think, we know very well, it is somewhat difficult. But without carrying the difficulties, we can do that. We can do that. The main thing is we have to start it. I think giving some powers to some different types of ethnicity is not a solution. It is the reason for starting another ethnic issue. Therefore, that is our stand in the steering committee. And we propose the real situation, the genuine situation, the genuine practical situation, to give the economic and political rights to individuals. If the individual can obtain more powers economically and politically, then the devolution of power is not necessary. Such a concept is not necessary, because the already power has devolved among the people. That is the change of system. So many people are talking about the Western type of words, but we need not such type of words, such type of political interferences, because those are the people who created such a situation in our country. India, America, and some other countries have ignored our internal issues, and they have created our problems. They have interfered, and they have increased some problems of our country. Therefore, we oppose to interfere any country from anywhere in the world. But we have to protect our human rights. That's why we are talking about protect human rights without considering the UNHRC. We proposed just after the war to implement the Truth and Reconciliation Commission in 26th of May in 2009. We are the first party who proposed that. After 7 years, the UNHRC, Navarindam Pillai, proposed to implement such a commission in our country. Why we were waiting for that? We don't care about other countries. As a country, as a people of our country, we have a right to protect our human rights. That is the responsibility of a government. That's why we proposed just after the vote to implement Truth and Reconciliation Commission in our country. That was happened 26th of May in 2009. The present government also promised to start Truth and Reconciliation Commission, but it has not started yet. That is the fault of this government. That is not the fault of JVP. Our principle is clear. Our practical program is clear. The problem is, it is not being taken, it is not being practiced. That's the problem. That's not the fault of the JVP principle. That's not the fault of the JVP program. That's the fault of the then governments and present government. The people voted for this government. Therefore, it was not practiced. Right. Then, he asked and he mentioned, according to his knowledge, JVP is a nationalistic party.
Progressive.
But whatever the adjective, we are not a nationalistic party. Actually, we are the party belongs to the Marx-Leninist theory. We have followed that theory. According to the Marx and according to the Lenin, there should not be any differences among people, among ethnicities. The whole proletariat must be together. That is the main theme. Our theme is same. We oppose to separatist movement because of the division of country, division of the people of our country. If you formed any type of separatist movement, then the people will divide into various groups. Unite is more important. Therefore, we are not a nationalistic party. We always do our political activities on behalf of the unite the people of our country. That is our main principle. It is in the manifesto and it is being practiced today also. When there was so many insurrection, Talukam and Dargatau, we were the party who opposed and who went that place first of all. And when I was a minister, cultural and national heritage minister, I started in film cooperation. Actually, there were no any Tamil section in that film cooperation. I started that separate unit for that. And I gave loans for the producers. There were five films, one for the children films, and one for the Tamil film. I ordered to produce a Tamil film because there are no Tamil films in our country. There are only few. Most of films are taken from India today also. There is no Tamil film industry. We are talking about the single film industry. And I was the minister who gave the Muslim school girls the hijab. There were many Muslim ministers were there. The Kabir Rasim was an education minister, but he could not do that. I was the person who did that. If we are nationalistic party, we did not do that. I wanted to mention those two examples. There are many examples. Therefore, in practice, we are not nationalistic. We are always thinking about all ethnicities. Only thing is, we opposed separatist movement. We opposed Indian intervention. At that time, at the very beginning of our party, we opposed the Indian intervention. Then some people said that JP was anti-Tamil party. We opposed the Indian intervention. That does not mean JP is an anti-Tamil party. It's just two things. And we opposed the LTT. Yes, we categorically opposed. Why? It's a separatist movement. Then some people said that JP was an anti-Tamil movement. It's a wrong, completely wrong interpretation. We protected so many Tamil people who faced difficulties in 1983. At that time, there were many Tamil comrades are doing political activities in our party, full times. But we were banned in 1983. What was the reason, according to the J.R. Jayawardena's explanation? We were the party who involved that insurrection. That's right. Was it correct? You agree with that? JVP was the party who responsible the 1983, right?
Still don't know, still suspicions are there.
Yes. He know very well.
Might be a good idea if you can shorten your speech and leave some time for the discussion.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, actually, I like to discuss it. I want to...
You have spent a lot of time.
No, only 1 hour.
For us, that is a long time.
For us, for you, 1 hour is a problem. Therefore, how to spend more hours? Right. Jokes. Actually, I wanted to mention those examples because I wanted to say we are not a nationalistic party. There was armed struggle in 1971 and 1989. We did not do any arms incident because of the ethnicity. We did some, we took some arms, that's correct, that's a famous thing, but we did not take any arms against any Tamil or Muslim people because of the difference of their ethnicity. Therefore, we are not nationalistic party. I wanted to categorize the last point of that. That's why. That's okay. I think this is the beginning of the discussion. I wanted to start that discussion. That's why I mentioned all those points. Then you can ask various questions according to your knowledge and your stand. No problem. There are some differences. That is the reality. Otherwise, we are not to be all together. We can discuss many things and I can say our party stand. Then you can take a decision whether it is right or wrong. You can take your decision. Okay, thank you very much.